Hello guys, my name is Siddhanshu Kapoor. I am your instructor. So today we talk about traffic manager in Azure. Okay, so this is also a load balancer type, you can say that, but it's a kind of application load balancer. Okay, so previously we already covered three load balancers. You can say that we can go for public load balancer, and then we can go for internal load balancer, and then we can go for zone redundant load balancer. Okay, so now today we talk about traffic manager. Okay, so let's start the topic, guys. So we have some theory part, we need to cover it. So what is traffic manager? So Azure traffic manager is a DNS based traffic load balancer that enables you to distribute traffic to services across global global Azure regions. It means that, like, imagine that like you can say that number one is that traffic, if you talk about the traffic manager, so traffic manager is used to distribute the traffic, okay, number one thing, or distribute the traffic between global Azure regions. It works with DNS. You can say that it works with the DNS based queries. Okay, so now where we can use traffic manager? Simple, traffic manager is used in your application services or web apps. Like, imagine if I open my Paint, I want to explain it once. Okay, so like this, like imagine that this is my Azure, you can see that. This is the one region, you can see that this is my East US region. Okay, and I have another region name. You can see that this is my East US, and we have a West US also. We can go for this is my West US region. Okay, now imagine that one of my application is running over there. I make one web app over there. This is my application. You can see that this is my web application. It's running. Web application. It's running in this East US. This is known as web application. Imagine that the application name is 123. Okay, or you can say that the application name is one. My application one is running over there, and we have another web application. Okay, and it's running in the different region. Okay, you can call it for web app application two. Okay, so this is my second application. It's running in East US region. Now I want to distribute the traffic between these two applications. Okay, so what can I do? I make one you can say that traffic manager load balancer. Okay, so I can put one traffic manager. Imagine that this is my traffic manager load balancer. Okay, imagine that this is my traffic manager load balancer. So we have a traffic manager load balancer, and what I do, I add these you can say that these apps. Okay, in this I add web app one also in this, okay, and web app two also in this, like this. Okay, and traffic manager load balancer has their own IP address. Like, imagine it uses, like, imagine something like 40.128.116.112. okay, like this. This is my this is the traffic manager load balancer IP address. So imagine that with the help of this, like, this is my client over there. Now I have a client. Okay, so client uses this IP addresses to access the request. Like, imagine this is my client. Okay, so what client do? Client use this IP address. Okay, client use this IP address, and you can say that client use this IP address to access the web apps. Okay, so like imagine if first like imagine that first queries sent to query goes to my load balancer. Okay, and then this load balancer forwards the query to, according to the methods that which I am using in the web apps. Okay, so according to the method, sometime request goes to web application one, and sometime request goes to web application two. Okay, so when I configuring traffic manager, we have some methods also. So we discuss this also. So number one is that what is traffic manager? With the help of traffic manager, we can manage or distribute traffic with the traffics in with the help of web apps, you can say that with the web application for different reasons. Okay, so like if you have multiple web apps and it's situated in different regions, so we can use Traffic Manager to manage the traffic or distribute the traffic. Okay, so if you're talking about this, so it's a simple definition that you can go for distribute traffic to services or apps across global Azure regions. Okay, now what are the advantages of this? Advantage is that increase application availability. Okay, like imagine that if my one app is down, because we have second app, okay, to provide the same resources. Okay, so we have increased availability also. Okay, we can go for multiple apps also. Like imagine if I have four apps running in different regions, so I can use one traffic manager and I can add all those four apps in that, and we can distribute the load. Okay, and provide high availability. Now after that, we have improved application performance. Of course, your application performance is improving. Okay, because there is no load, it divides the load between two apps. You can say that. Okay, some requester goes there, some requester goes there. Okay, and it's a DNS based request. You can say that. Okay, when you're using Traffic Manager on the background, DNS queries are running over there. Okay, fine. So like this. And then after that, performing service maintenance without downtime. Like imagine if my one app is in maintenance mode, so I have a second app to resolve the queries. You can say that. So when your client access to this IP address, actually this is not an IP address we access. Okay. So when you configure Traffic Manager, they have two things: one public IP address, and second is the link. So we can provide the link to the client. Okay, so one link is automatically created when we create a Traffic Manager, load balancer, and the help of that link, we can able to access the app. So if imagine that if my one app is in maintenance mode, this app is not working, but this app is down, you can see that it's running in maintenance mode. So we have a second app to manage all the stuff. So manage all the DNS queries which the client is requested. Okay, so like this, we can go for that. Okay, fine. So I hope you're able to understand these things. Advantages means increase application availability, means the same thing. If my one app is down, second app is there to provide the resources to manage the DNS queries. Improve application performance, like there is no load on only one app. If you have multiple apps, so the load the performance is very good because the load is distributed. Now the next one is performance, application maintenance without downtime. Services or application means if your one service or one application is in maintenance mode, so you have at least second app to who is there to provide the or to resolve the DNS DNS queries which is based on clients. Okay, so whatever queries client send to Traffic Manager, it is all by another app. Okay, now we have some methods. Now if I want to deploy Traffic Manager, so we have some methods. Number one is priority. So what is the meaning of priority over there? Like imagine I have two apps, like same thing, I can use the same thing. Like this is my again my two regions, you can say that. Okay, and in this region, this is my again, this is the East US region. Okay, and East US region. Okay, and I have again we have a West US region I have. Okay, now imagine that over there my web app, you can see that web app one is running. Okay, and over there my application name is web app two is running. Okay, so the same thing, like imagine that when I add those apps in the Traffic Manager, this is my Traffic Manager load balancer. Okay, this is the Traffic Manager load balancer. So I am adding these apps now. So imagine that first I add app one over there. Okay, so imagine I app first app in this, and then I can add second app in this. It means that, like imagine that I give priority app one to one. I give priority one to this app, okay, and I give priority second to this app. Okay, so what happens if Traffic Manager accepts the queries? First, Traffic Manager sends the query to priority one app. Okay, and then it sends the query to priority second app. So you can say that like this. Okay, so always remember that the like if you want that, okay, all my queries first sent to web app one, if my if and after that you can send to web app 2. Okay, so also if you want that, I want all the queries in web app 1, so set the priority 1 on web app 1. Okay, so it always works on less priority. The application who has less priority always receive the queries first. Okay, and the application who has highest priority always receive the queries second, like this. Okay, so we can define the priority based also. Okay, that where my queries goes first. After that we have a weightage. Okay, so we can go for weightage also. Okay, or weightage also. So like imagine that I can set the weightage. Like imagine now we have multiple apps. Like I tell that okay, this is I can provide the weightage. Imagine let's go for like imagine this is my 100. I set the weightage. What the weightage always we can use between 1 to 1000 numbers. It's a numerical numbers. Okay, so like imagine that I set the weightage like there, like this. I have imagine one more app also. So this is also I have another region. Imagine this is my another region. Okay, you can call it's a Central India region. Okay, and you can say that this is over there. I'm using web app 3. Okay, and this web app also connect. I just add this web app also in this traffic manager. Okay, it's added over there. So now what happens? Like imagine that in web app 1 I can set the weightage 100. Okay, in web app 2 I set the weightage imagine 80 over there. Okay, and in web app 3 I set the weightage imagine 60 like this. Okay, weightage depend on your capacity. You can say that the speed and the bandwidth and all those stuffs. Okay, so we can calculate the weightage with the help of bandwidth and speed and all those stuffs. Okay, so like imagine I can use over there 100. Imagine that this application I've set the weightage 100. In this application I set the weightage 80, and this app I set the weightage 60. Okay, so first it sees the higher weightage. So first request goes to there, and then after that there, and then after that there, like this. So we can provide, so we can set the servers also with the help of weightage systems also. Okay, so you can use weightage, you can use priority. Okay, the two method we have. Okay, now the another method we have is known as performance. Now performance means that, like imagine, performance means that the nearest endpoints. Like imagine, if I choose the another paint and I'll go for that. Like imagine this, and I have so many regions are there. Like imagine I have 3 to 5 regions are there, 4 regions I have. Okay, this region is my imagine again, this is again the east US one. Okay, this is west US one. Okay, this is Central India, and this is the Asia region, Asia Pacific region, you can say that Asia Pacific. Okay, so these are the regions we have. Okay, so now imagine that every region has their unique clients. Like imagine over there we have in East US connect. Like imagine in East US we have 100 clients in East US. Okay, and imagine that after that we have 50 clients in 50 clients. In West US. Okay, now imagine I have again like imagine that I have again in Central India I have 200 clients who regularly access my web app. Okay, my web applications. Okay, and in Pacific imagine that I have 500 clients. Okay, which is regularly access my okay, so my web app. So we have over there web app. Like imagine over there using web app 1. Okay, over there I'm using imagine web app 2. Over there I'm using imagine web app 3. And over there I'm using imagine web app 4. Okay, like this. Okay, so now imagine that one of the client sent request. Okay, so first traffic manager sees over there. Like imagine all these apps connect with the traffic manager. So first, like imagine this is my traffic manager. I can go over the traffic manager. This is the traffic manager, you can show that. Okay, this is the traffic manager we have. This is traffic manager. Okay, load balancer. Okay, so now imagine that imagine that one East US client sends him a request. You can say that, like one East US client sends him request. Okay, like this. One East US client sends him request. Okay, so he checks where the request comes. He checks. Okay, its request comes with East US client. Okay, so the location of the client who is working with East US. Okay, so he automatically sends the queries to East US. Web app. Like imagine that somehow what happens, this web app is in maintenance mode. Now imagine that this web app is in maintenance mode. This is in maintenance mode. Okay, so now what happens in that case? So again, one of the client which is working in East US sends the request. Now East US and West US is just like East US has been running in maintenance, so it automatically sends the request to West US, because West US is nearer than East US. Okay, means West US is near. Okay, so if he sends the request to Central India and Asia Pacific, so these servers are very far. Okay, so it's checks the closest endpoint, you can say that. Your traffic manager in the performance method, what he checks the closest endpoint. Who is the closest one? Okay, and he checks, okay, this is the closest one, he sends the request to that particular web app. Okay, like imagine if the request goes to Central India. Okay, now imagine that this again Central India is in maintenance mode. Imagine this app is in maintenance mode, so he automatically sends the request to Asia Pacific, because Central India is Asia Pacific is near than, or you can say Central India is near than this Asia Pacific, like this. Okay, so it like your traffic manager checks in performance method, traffic manager checks where the closest point for this request. So he sends the closest application. Okay, like this. So this is the very best method, you can say that we are using in traffic manager. Okay, now we have a geographical is also the you can say that in geographical also it goes to the geographical locations. Okay, it uses the geographical locations only. Okay, fine. So like the same thing which I already told you, like if the request goes to comes to East US, so it sends the request to East US web app only. Okay, so geographical location means where the queries originate from, you can say that, where the queries comes. Okay, it sends the query to that particular location. Okay, now we have a multiple value option is also there. Now this method is very very good. Multiple value option method is a very good method. Like in that, your request goes to multiple servers, not only one servers. Okay, it works with IPv4 and IPv6 also. IPv4 and IPv6 IP addresses. You can say that. Okay, so like imagine that if you're using this, okay, so what happens in that case? Okay, your request goes to that location multiple servers. So requests are managed by multiple servers, you can say that. So we can use multi-value means the request goes to multiple servers. Okay, now we have the subnet option also. Now subnet option is very very good. Like imagine that over there we can map the applications. Like I tell them, like imagine that we have again the same thing, we have multiple locations, like the same thing we have. Okay, we have again the four region, you can say that we have the four locations. Okay, this is one is the again the West US, this is again East US, this is Central India. Okay, and this is you can say that Asia Pacific. Okay, so I'm sorry, Pacific. Okay, fine. So like imagine that if you understand, this is known as Asia Pacific. Okay, like this. Okay, so now imagine that over there web app 1 is running. Okay, over there web app 2 is running. Okay, over there web app 3 is running, and over there web app 4 is running. Okay, now imagine what happens, that is again we have a you have a traffic manager is there, and all the apps are added in the traffic manager. Okay, I'm adding all the apps in the traffic manager load balancer. Okay, so all the apps are automated, already connected with this. Okay, I'm adding all my apps in this traffic manager. Okay, like this. Now imagine that I map over there. Like I map with the subnet. You can say that. Like imagine I tell that if queries comes with I can use over there subnet is 11.0.0.0/8. If queries goes to this subnet, comes to this subnet, okay, it's automatically redirect the queries to West US application one. Okay, if queries goes to, imagine that if queries goes to 11.1.0.0/24 subnet over there, imagine I can use over there 24 also. Sorry, 16 over there, you can use, imagine. Go 16. And over there also, I'm going to use 16. Okay, so like this, use 16. Okay, over there, I'm also use 16. Okay, so what happens is that if the queries comes to 11.1.0.0/16 subnet, so traffic manager automatically redirect the queries to East US Web 2. Okay, now the queries goes to 11.2.0.0/16 subnet. Okay, so what happens in that case, the traffic manager automatically redirect the query to Central India, and the if the queries goes to 11, if the query comes to 11.3.0.0/16, so automatically traffic manager sends the query to Asia Pacific. Okay, so in what happens in subnet, in subnet method, what happens, traffic manager maps all the subnets, all the region and the subnets with there. Okay, so it maintains, you can say it maintains the table, something like this. Okay, so it maintains the table and it maintains that, okay, if West US running that sub 11 subnet, East US running 11.1 subnet, Central India running 11.2 subnet, Asia Pacific running 11.3 subnet. Okay, so if queries comes to 11.0.0/16 subnet, so it automatically redirect to West US location app, region app. Okay, like this. So this is also a very good method we are using in our managing or distribute the traffic in multiple Azure regions. Okay, like this. Okay, so I hope you're able to understand all the methods are available in traffic manager. Okay, now let's start the practical, guys. Okay, this is the theoretical part, so we can discuss about methods. Okay, I hope you're able to understand the methods now let's start the practical. So in practical, what we can do, we need to create, you can say that we can create two. Number one, we can create two web apps, number one, okay, in different regions. Okay, number second point, we can create, can create like this your traffic manager load balancer. Okay, and number third, we can add these two apps, web apps, in traffic manager load balancer. Okay, okay, fine, like this. Okay, and after that we can go for testing. Then after that, testing. Okay, like this. This is the things you need to do. Okay, so let's start the practical, guys. Now this is, I am already logging with my Azure portal. Okay, now first you can create the web apps. Okay, so just search over there, web app. So you can see that we have the options. Maybe here is the web app. Okay, the simple click on web app. App services, maybe it's in app services. Scroll down, go to all resources. Create a resource. Go to create a resource. Over there, you can search. Yeah, it is web app. Okay, just click on web app. Okay, so what we can do, you need to go to just create a resource. Okay, just click on create a resource. Over there, we have the option web app. Click on web app. Okay, Now I'm going to create two apps. Okay, so this is the web app. So this, they asked me to create the resource group first. Okay, so I'm going to create a resource group also. So I'm creating a new, create a new resource group. Okay, so this is the web app RG. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I'm using this resource group name is web app rg. Okay, now I need to give the name of the web app. Okay, so my name of the web app is web app one. Okay, so there is no space, so web app one, I hope it's taken. No, 2 3. Okay, web app 1988 something, call it takes, it's a unique one, it's not available. This week, so it takes web app 56. Okay, it takes the common name, so that's why it takes time. So I use publish, so I'm using the code, okay, over there. Okay, and over there I'm using the Windows. Okay, so they asked me on which you can say that on which stack you can create the web app. Okay, so I'm creating using this, keep the, okay, I go for .NET. Okay, and I'm using the Windows web app. Okay, this is the runtime stack is, these the background is .NET. I'm using the .NET and operating system using Windows. Okay, now I'm choosing over there East US. You can say that if you have East US, the option is East US. I say have East US because I'm choosing East US over there. Okay, on the down it automatically take the Windows plan, and SKU it automatically take the size. Okay, fine. So like this, click on next. Now I don't want anything in monitoring, so click on no. There is no monitoring and all. Okay, click on tags. Okay, so I need to give the name, and this is my web app. Okay, click on next. Now it's going to create my web app. Okay, so this web app name is web 56. Okay, now it's validating. If everything is fine, they showing me create option. Okay, so as you can see that it's the reviewing is completed now. So I think one thing I also told you that when you click on basic again, and over there they give you the Windows the app service plan, so you can create a new also, and it's automatically create the new also. Okay, if you want to create new, you can give the name also with your you can say that with your familiar name. Okay, by default taking the complex name, so I give my name, so it's known as my service plan. You can go like this. Okay, click on OK. So I'm using the name my service plan. So you can use the by default name also. You can give the give the your name also. So I give my my specific name. Okay, and it's taking automatically the size of that. Okay, now simple is that, it's everything is fine now. Okay, click on monitoring. It's okay, I don't want any monitoring things. Click on tag. Okay, I already gave this. Now it's again check the validating. If everything is fine, okay, they're showing me create option. Okay, I click on create now. So as you can see that it's creating my web app. Okay, so as you can see that the web app is created successfully. Okay, now I'm going to home. Okay, click on web app again. Okay, web app. Now I'm going to create another web app. Okay, one web app is already created. Okay, now I'm going to create another one. So I'm using the same resource group web app RG. Now I'm going to go for this one is web app 57. Previously I gave 56, now I choose 57. Okay, now the same thing, stack I using .NET core. Okay, Windows over there I'm using you can say that East US, West US, if I see over there West US, West UK, West US. Okay, so I'm using over there West US. Okay, previously I'm using East US, now I'm using West US. Okay, and I choose, okay, it's changing again. So I need to give the plan again. So this is the my service plan one. This one, this time I can use plan one. Sorry, plan two. Plan one is already created. I click on OK. OK, and click on next. I don't want any monitoring. OK, click on next. You need to give the tags name. Name and this okay. Now it's validating again if everything is fine. Okay, and so you understand that we can choose the plan. So plan means it's your SKU and size, everything is automatically okay. So we have a different type of size also. Okay, so like this, click on create now. Whereas you can see that it's initializing and then it's going to create the web app also. Okay, so as you can see that my web app is created also. So I just click on home and click on resource groups. So over there you can found in web app RG, we can found that we have two web app is automatically created. Okay, here is the web app 56, and you just click on refresh once. They're showing me web app 57 also. Here it is, 56 and 57, two web app is successfully created. Okay, fine. Just a minute. Okay, so as you can see that the web app is created successfully. Web app 56 created in East US and 57 created is West US, and the plan is also created. Okay, now I need to go to home and go to traffic manager. So I just search over there traffic manager profiles. Okay, through which we can create traffic manager load balancer. Let's click on this traffic manager. Okay, now click on add over there. Okay, now I need to give the traffic manager name over there. Okay, so I need to give the traffic manager name as TF load balancer. Maybe it's taking. Okay, fine. Now I need to give the name. I need to just go for that which method I want to use. Okay, fine. So I'm choosing over the priority basis now. Okay, we can see how we with the help of priority method. So we mostly use priority methods. Okay, but this is a very good method, so I'm using this now. Okay, and after that I'm using now I need to configure the resource group. So I already created the resource group web app RG. okay, which I already created. Okay, in that I need to go for okay, and so where I need to give the priority, so they need to give me okay, for first priority automatically goes to East US, you can say that. Okay, so I choose go for web app. So this first priority automatically goes to East US. Okay, now click on create over there. So it's going to check the validation. Okay, so as you can see that the traffic manager load balancer is created now. I go to home and click on traffic manager profiles. As you can see that TF load balancer, the name is created. It's go for priority basis now. Now click on this. Now I need to click on endpoints, and I need to click on add all both my apps. So click on add over there. Okay, choose the name of there. This is the you can say that point one. Okay, and I choose over there app services because I work on app services. Now choose the app services. So we have two apps. I choose web app 56 first. Okay, I give the priority one to my web app 56. Okay, like imagine if you want to give web app 57, so you can choose web app 57 over there. Okay, so that which app you want to give the priority one, you can choose the app. So I give priority one to this. Okay, and simply click on OK over there. So as you can see that it's saving my first point. Okay, so I'm adding the apps now. So it's adding my first app. You can see that point one is created now. Okay, now I can click on add again. And I'm going to choose the second point, so this is my point two. Okay, it means endpoint two. You can say that we can choose over there endpoint two. Now let's click on app services. Okay, it's already there. Point one, I'm sorry, it's point two. Okay, so I think it's okay. Now click on choose app. Now this time choosing web 57. This is the priority two for web 57. Okay, click on OK now. So you can see that it's saving the points. Okay, so as you can see that my web app is successfully, means you can say that I'm adding all my web apps in the traffic manager as known as endpoints. Okay, so my web app 56 is a priority one and web app 57 is a priority two. Okay, so now it means the first queries goes to web app 56 and then goes to web app 57. Okay, now click on overview over there. Okay, over there you can find the DNS name over there. You can see that there is no IP address. Okay, they're showing me my DNS names because the queries goes to DNS name. So I need to check with this. Okay, I copy this DNS name. Okay, I open the browser and check whether my app is able to open or not. So you can see that the app is developer, so my app is running over there. You can see that your app is up and running. You can see that your app is up and running. Okay, now imagine that. Now imagine what happens now. Now I disabled my priority one app. Imagine I just click on this, okay, and I disabled this. You can see that, okay, and click on save. Now we check whether the app is running or not again. Okay, let's see, it disabled now. Okay, we will go for traffic manager. Okay, and you can see that it disabled now. Now I'm trying to go for again. Okay, enter it. So you can see that still my app service is running because now the query goes to app number 2, 57 app. Okay, app number 57. Okay, now imagine that. Now what happens in that case? I disabled this also. Now my both our apps are disabled now. It means now the queries are bounced now. Now this time I'm not able to access the query. Okay, you can say that. Okay, now this time they give me the error. Like, let's see what happens. It takes some time. It takes 1 to 2 minutes. Okay, and it's showing me there is no app is running. Okay, just refresh once, and it takes 2 minutes minimum to disable all the stuffs. Okay, just wait for 2 minutes. Okay, so let's see if I open another browser and I try to copy it again. Okay, so you can see that. See. Now my web app is not running. Why? Because all the web app endpoints are disabled. So now traffic manager, what happens in that case, that the queries goes to traffic manager and traffic manager doesn't have the resolve the queries. Why? Because both the apps are not running in this case. Understood now? Okay, so like this, how we can go for traffic manager and how we can implement traffic manager load balancer on my web apps. Okay, so that's it for this video, guys. If you have any doubt, any queries, please let me know. Please comment me on this video. Please like this video. Please share this video with your friends. Okay. Hope you're able to understand this video. Okay. Thank you for watching, guys.